Welcome to the Community Show Be Restored TV show. I'm your host, Prophet Cedric Banks, along with
Prophetess Donetta Banks.
Got a great show for you today. We got a young man sitting on the right of me. He's from the Michigan Science Center. You know, there's some incredible things that go down at the Michigan Science Center. Some beautiful things go down at the Science Center. It's an educational place.
It is.
And you know, we are presenting this to you here today because the Lord put in my spirit that we need to get to moving more, begin to develop more of a life, begin to illustrate some more positive things in your life that can do you well, that can enhance your happiness, that can enhance your well-being, that can bring life to you. And we got a young man right here named Christian Greer. He's a representative of Michigan Science Center, and he's got some great things today what he's getting ready to talk to us about.
Well, Prophet, I'm happy to be here.
I'm happy to have you.
You know, I'm new to Detroit.
Oh, wow.
So I haven't been everywhere in Detroit yet. So it's good to be out here to your ministry and to meet some of your parishioners and all the people that help support what you're doing. Because restoring the community is exactly what we should be doing. And if there's any way that we can help that process, we want to do it.
Yeah, you all went online and checked us out here?
We did, yeah. We went online to learn more about your ministry.
Well, how did you like it? What'd you think?
I thought it was fantastic. I even had a chance to see some of your previous shows, and I got a chance to see some of the people who have been on your show, really influential leaders.
Yeah.
Some of the people making a difference in Detroit and want to see things change.
So I bring on the best company.
You bring on the best, so I'm happy to be in that company.
Things that go on at the Science Center. Tell us about the Science
Center.
For someone who's never been there,
yeah,
that's watching, would you present to them?
You know, the Michigan Science Center is an interesting place because more than anything, we really want to focus on the curious mind. You know, have you ever seen a lightning strike? Or you look up in the sky and you see the sun and the clouds moving? Or maybe there might even be a small creature that is in the grass making its way. And you might have questions about how do they live, what do they eat, what do they do? And what science is really about, and a science center is, it just gives you an opportunity to really experience this and draw conclusions on your own. So, but we do that in a hands-on way, interactive. So it's not quite like a classroom environment that you might get at a university or K-12 school. It's mainly based on your own interaction with something so that you can convince yourself about what you're seeing and what's cool about science.
How long you been here?
I've been in Detroit for about 4.5 months.
Okay.
And I'm from Chicago originally, so I'm a Midwestern kid. And I've been to Detroit a number of years. As a matter of fact, when I first came to Detroit, way back when, it was just several years after the Renaissance Center was built when I was a little boy. And we got a chance to go up that outside elevator, the glass elevator, and I thought that was the coolest thing. That's what I remember most about being in Detroit. But since I've been here, the people have been so welcoming. I came here from St. Louis, where I'd worked at the St. Louis Science Center for about 5 years, and I just could not believe just how open and welcoming the people of Detroit have been. Good people here, and they're making a difference in the community, trying to turn things around.
Detroit, I'm going to tell you this. Detroit's really going to be sweet to you.
Yeah, so far
it's
going to
turn out to be sweet.
I appreciate that, Prophet.
Yeah, take it what is where it's going to be sweet to you. I can see it.
I love it. I appreciate that because I want to come here and our organization, you know, to really serve these young kids. You know, the future is really in science, technology, and engineering and math from an economic standpoint. But the skills skills are very important for them to get, and we need to make sure that it's available to them so that they can take part of this economy, build businesses, start community centers, be able to command certain kinds of opportunities through their knowledge, and if we can help that, we'd like to.
So when you say hands-on experiences, what do you really mean? You say when you see an animal walk by, you'll be able to experience it. I mean, is this like you see in a theater, 3D, 3D or something?
Yeah, that's interesting that you bring that up. We do have what's called a 4D theater. So you've heard, most of the things that you watch are really in two dimensions. There's a Y direction and an X direction. You know, just like you see something on a screen on your phone. In three dimensions, it looks like what we look, if you look at your hands right now, you're seeing them in three dimensions. But four dimensions in a presentation actually does other things. Like we will send a jet of air towards you when we're flying over a scene, like a mountain, or water will spray on you when we're showing a video of you going to the beach. So it kind of feels like you're there. And that's what we want to do for people who have maybe never been to Everest or people who have never been to the Amazon. How do you get them to see what that's like, even though they may have never traveled there? So we try to create environment using technology. It's a 4D theater. The Toyota Engineering Theater is how we do it.
At the Michigan Science Center?
At the Michigan Science Center.
Oh, so it's all a theater, and you go in?
Absolutely. As a matter of fact.
And watch everything on the theater?
We have a theater with different shows that do 4D, and you know, Prophet, if you'd like to bring some of your church members out, I'll have them. You can be my guest, and we'll come out and show you.
We'll be there for yourself.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Write it down. We'll be there.
Just this past week, we had a program called Harvest Fest. Now, I had never experienced this before. I don't know if anybody was there in your group that went to Harvest Fest, but it's a group in the city of Detroit that tries to find safe places for kids to go trick-or-treating. You know, and not only do they receive candy, but they receive natural foods like fruits and vegetables as well for this evening. But the place was packed. We had hundreds of people. We were trying to create an environment for them to be able to do something safe. And so we had that at the Science Center just this past week for Halloween.
Oh, okay, that's really great. So when they came here, you were giving out food and all those kinds of things?
Yes, it wasn't so much us, we were the host.
Okay.
It was another community organization that was working on
the Science Center.
Called Harvest Fest, yeah.
Okay, that's really wonderful. So I'm very interested in all these different theaters that you have. I
mean, yes.
So what are some of the, how do you do it? Do you go by like topics of
we
family?
Do sometimes,
like, I mean,
right, sometimes it's
set your agenda for the theaters.
That's a great question. You know, we usually pick themes that are of interest to the public. So
okay.
We have a planetarium, which is a theater, and the interesting thing about the planetarium is it's a domed theater.
Okay.
Much like when you look up at the sky, it kind of is infinite in all directions. And creating that theater where you can fly through the universe, just the vastness of the universe is almost unfathomable to us as human beings. But you get to explore that. And all we do is show it.
Okay, so you make it real to the person.
We try to make it real, yeah. So if you have an interest in space, just how vast it is,
yes.
The universe that we're in is almost beyond imagination, how big it is. It really is. I mean, you think about the traveling into space or sending probes out into space to discover things. The universe just continues to go on and on and on.
So is that one of your regular events?
Yeah, we have a nighttime planetarium show and one where we explore the solar system.
Okay.
And we do that on a regular basis.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what else do you have that you do on
a regular basis? We have a program called our STEM and Easter program. Our STEM and Easter program is for young girls interested in science, technology, engineering, and math. And believe it or not, I believe we have over 1,400 girls that have signed up for this program.
Okay.
And they connect with young women, scientists, technologists, engineers, and mathematicians that work out there to give them examples to follow. And they serve kind of as mentors for these young women that want to participate. So if you have young women in your church that are interested in science, maybe they've done a science fair project or they're very inquisitive about the universe, hey, we can get them involved in our Seminista program.
It's called Seminista.
Steminista.
Steminista. Okay, yep. Yeah, I understand the STEM program.
Right, exactly. Okay. So that's one of the programs that we have. We also do summer camps. I have two kids, and my kids were in the summer camp this year. They had a blast, you know, exploring things and learning about different scientific concepts. So that was kind of fun as well.
Oh, wow. Okay, so that's really interesting. So it's not just... it's not just a theater, because when you're doing mentorship programs, you're into some type of classroom environment or something like that.
That's right. Sometimes it's into exactly a seminar, workshop, or a classroom environment, or something even more relaxed where we had an overnight experience where the kids spent the night and got a chance to talk science and
they
do something
spent the
fun.
Night in the science
center. Right. Oh, so we don't do that all the time, but it is an opportunity for them to just kind of live and breathe their interest. You know, when kids are young, they don't always have people around them with the same interests. And it makes it challenging for them to be able to learn and grow if they don't have friends with similar interests. If you're a parent like me, you see your kids and you're thinking, gosh, I wish I could introduce them to other kids with similar values. I'm sure your church members would agree, and interests, and try to connect them so they can learn and grow together. Kids learn a lot from each other, sometimes good and bad. But we want them to learn from each other the good stuff, right?
For
so
sure.
That's kind of definitely important. And it helps them with their schoolwork in their K-12 education because they feel like they're in it together.
So what's the telephone number? How will people connect to that, you know, to the program?
Right. Well, the best way to connect with the Michigan Science Center is to go online to our website. And it's MySci. Or my-sci.org. So MI for Michigan dash sci, SCI for science.org. That's my-sci.org. And we have our hours, we have our programs. As a matter of fact, we have a sponsored free day on November 10th. That's next Sunday. And it's going to be free of charge. You can get your tickets online or you can get your tickets on site and come in for free to the Science Center. You know, normally the cost is. I believe $10 or $11 for children and $14 for adults. And next Sunday we'll be free from noon to, I believe, 5 p.m. And it's sponsored by a local automotive company called Denso. So we want you guys to come out and check it out.
Right. Tamiko.
Are tickets limited? Meaning, what if someone have a family of 4, 5, 10, or 12?
Right.
You have a certain amount that you're willing to give out for free.
Yes, the tickets are limited, but not so much on the individual level. It's more for how many people come through during the day. So if we have a set maximum capacity of people coming in, that's one of the reasons why we want to ticket it, to make sure that people can get in effectively and we can count how many people come to the events so we know what to prepare for next time. But I don't think you'll have any problem at all bringing a big group to come down. We're hoping you come down and see what we have to offer because we want to take the advice from the public to change some of our exhibits and do some cool things on new topics, whatever they might be.
You know, we bring the people on this show right here. You see what type of people come on this show, right?
Yep.
We bring the people on this show right here where it can help people develop a life. Because many Christians and many church folks need to develop a life. Like I said, we done brought on the mayor, all the city council, and you've seen all the state representatives, many judges.
You're pretty connected. You're pretty well connected there. You got all the folks in there.
Right. But see, I thank God that he have given me that influence to for these type of people to believe in me. But it's for the reason why, because the show ranks number one in the city of Detroit, right?
Wow.
Teresa? Number one.
Right.
And when you is up there like that, you have to deliver, because the people on Saturday night at 8 o'clock is looking. They tuned in, they looking.
Yeah, they could be doing other things, but they're watching you.
Right, they tuned in, they looking for results. People that can help the city. People got answers. They looking for that. You see what I'm saying? We bring the the low people on. We everywhere, the man in the gutter, the woman in the gutter. We don't forget them, because I got a heart for them people too. So we bring them on too. It ain't just stature. No, it ain't just stature. A lady came up to me one time, I thought you just bring on prominent people. But I saw you, I said, no. I got a heart, the name of my ministry is the Heart of Jesus now. So you can't have the Heart of Jesus if you're just looking for stature, you know what I mean? So we well-rounded, you know, we looking for that man that's in the gutter, in the pit, that's got a testimony that God has brought him out, that God has did something for him. You know, we're rounded. We bring on Skillman Foundation, Kellogg's Foundation, Kresge Foundation. These are organizations that give out. The Skillman Foundation give out $100 million in grant money a year. $100 million.
Amen.
Just like right there. Raise your hand. God go help you with a grant. You looking for a grant? Right here, we bring out the Skillman Foundation, Kellogg's, Kresge, all them that give out. What do Skillman give out of here, Teresa? You know, you connected, you my administrator, let you handle my network. What they give out a year?
Yeah, like you just said, plus $100 million a year.
And grant money. Mm-hmm. They have been on this show.
Well, you know, I think it's really interesting to get support from the foundations, because many of them are looking for people that are mission related, that want to make a difference. And I think that what you're doing with your show is so important, because we can't do it alone. You know, I think that's what you're saying with the community being restored. You have to believe that it can change in order to restore something. We have a similar belief at the Science Center. You know, as educators, you have to believe that somebody can learn and that they can change.
Right.
And you also mentioned this idea of people that, you know, very prominent versus not. As part of your ministry, I think it's important too for us as a Science Center. Many of us go through school and we take science classes and we think, maybe science isn't for me. But really, asking questions and going through the process is what every human being can do. And we shouldn't pick who can be a scientist and who can't. It's a natural right you have to be able to ask questions about the universe and appreciate it. You know, my interest in science was in astronomy. And I thought, just looking through a telescope at just the vastness of the universe, as we were talking earlier, is just an incredible experience if people haven't seen it. And it humbles you when you just see how vast the universe is. And that's something that we want to give people an opportunity to see, so that they can learn more about who they are and their place, and how we can make a difference, whether it's out in the universe and looking at that, being inspired to do something right here at home in the community. I think we all need to do it.
Beautiful.
You know, kids learn in hands-on, minds, all kinds of ways. They want to touch things. Sometimes it's hard to get them to sit in a seat because their senses are just on fire. They just want to ask questions and try things. So we just take advantage of that and allow them to be able to explore in that environment, to be able to feel free to explore science, whether it's biology, chemistry, physics, astronomy, earth science. We just got a grant from General Motors. They generously gave us money to build a weather exhibit. Wow. And so many people ask about the weather, especially this week when it's changing, there's a change of seasons, and we're hoping to get a Doppler radar feed and to work with, at a national level, to find out weather around the world, as well as atmospheric data, and even things like earthquakes that happen around the world. How do we learn more about these, and how do we bring them to the people of Detroit? When I was in Chicago, I was the chair of the board of directors for the Chicago Public Schools Science Fair. And during that time, we had hundreds of projects that came in. And some of the ones that...
How long you lived in Chicago?
I lived in Chicago most of my life, most of my adult life. I went
Did you meet Michael Jordan?
I have had a brush with Michael Jordan once.
Okay.
And it was in Chicago State University in a gymnasium that wasn't that much different from this. As a matter of fact, it's interesting you touched on that, because when I walked in, you know, that's the first
it
thing
It was just
I thought
in
about.
My spirit to say that. Normally, you know, who meets first, Michael Jordan?
And that's the first thing I thought about. And what happened was, a good friend of mine that I ended up double dating with on prom, his name is Michael Strautmanis. And Michael Strautmanis actually worked, he was President Barack Obama's chief counsel when he was in the Senate and worked in his administration, and now he's with the Obama Foundation.
Because Obama from Chicago.
Yeah, that's right. And he spent a lot of time in Chicago at some prominent law firms there. And but Mike's dad had a connection to media, and they were filming a Nike commercial. And so they were filming it. If you remember the one where he jumped up and it almost looked like he was walking
right,
on air.
Right.
I was there for that commercial.
Really?
And so what happened was, is Michael threw the basket up and it missed, which everyone was like, well, I didn't know he could miss one. But, you know, he's still human, right?
Right.
He's still fallible. But he missed, his airness missed the shot, and somehow or another, it bounced my way. And it was almost like a light shined on me. And so I go up and I grab the basketball and I freeze for that moment. And he looks at me, Prophet Banks, he looks at me like, what are you waiting, you know, give it a pill.
Right.
So I throw it back to him, he takes the ball and goes and dunks it. But that was my one little brush with Michael Jordan. It's interesting you bring that up because it was in a place very similar to this location.
Wow. I mean, you know, it was just in my spirit to mention that. I mean, if somebody was on a show from New York or
right.
Golden State, you know, I wouldn't just say, have you met Steph Curry?
Exactly.
I mean, that don't make sense. But it was just in my spirit. You see what I'm saying?
The
action, did you meet Michael Jordan?
I think it was
strong in my spirit.
It's right there.
Just like when I prophesied, it was strong in my spirit. You know,
I love
it. What do you make of that?
That's incredible.
What do you make of that, Teresa?
That's awesome.
Because they have seen me prophesy so much with accuracy. But you know, you only been in Detroit 4 months.
Just 4 months.
I like you.
Yeah.
This is a great church right here every Sunday at 2. You're welcome anytime.
Maybe I'll come back. Yeah, I bring a few people. I think it would be great for us to come out. And maybe there's an opportunity for us to partner and work together to bring opportunities and help restore the community.
Let's do it.
That's what we're doing, right?
Let's do it. I trust you. Let's partnership. Yeah, so wonderful. Pastor Joyce, go ahead.
I taught 30 years in the DPS.
Oh, you did?
So 30 years as a school teacher.
I give you a round of applause.
I am too.
Kids love science. Mm-hmm. And the hands-on is special. Because I sell them now. And you talk about science, they're going crazy.
Right.
When I take them to the science center, they love it. But what I want to say, I think, do you have representatives that go to the school and stir the kids up about science?
Mm-hmm. That's a good question.
And also the parents, they can start going to the parent meetings, stirring the parents up about science.
You know, I think you're onto something because, you know,
a
parent is almost a child's first teacher, you know, when they grow up and a family is created and you're nurturing that child. You give them an opportunity to learn how they're supposed to learn about the world. And we don't equip parents with enough, whether it's scientific knowledge, whether it's history, whether it's reading, writing, math. All parents, especially in early childhood, they need to be equipped to help. And so we have done workshops where we have coordinated with parents, and we do what in our world is called outreach programs. So we do science outreach programs where we go out to community centers, YMCAs, churches we've been to, and particular libraries which are in the community to do different programs so that even if you can't get to the science center, we want to be able to come to you and bring it to you because everyone deserves the opportunity and the access to science, technology, engineering, and math, and especially kids that are in school because they're already learning it. But we give them another way to learn it through this hands-on activities. It's just the idea that when you're manipulating an object or you're trying to try something out, you learn through your senses. That's the way everyone naturally learns. But sometimes in a formal environment, we emphasize the abstract and the cognitive side. But and you can learn that way. A lot of math is abstract, but it's not as fun as playing around with things, right? So we try to make it fun for the kids and give them a chance to learn math, whether it's algebra, arithmetic, geometry, trigonometry, calculus, whatever it might be. They can learn it at a variety of different ages if you just give them a chance.
You know, that's beautiful. Oh, you are one, appear to be one who bring a lot of life to people. I can just see you bring a lot of life to,
thank you,
to folks, you know. And I'm sure people come from all over to see the Michigan Science Center, right? Yeah,
that's right.
They come from
that's
all right. over, you know. And I tell you, you only been here 4 months, but I promise you, Detroit will be good to you.
I like that.
Your heart, it's going to melt your heart. Watch what I tell you.
Yeah, that's
you know, I can see it. I see it in a spiritual realm.
Prophet, it's been good so far. And I think what it is that what I'm getting for the people here, and perhaps you can shed some light on it for me, is the resiliency. You know, when you have somebody who's been through something, they don't need to brag about it. Somebody who's really been through something.
Right.
Because sometimes even going back to it is hard. And in school, when you're learning STEM, for example, you know, maybe people pick that up on me because I certainly been through my tough time. I majored in physics. I went to Morehouse College in Atlanta, Georgia.
Wow.
And it wasn't easy. No. As a matter of fact, one of my professors was a Tuskegee Airman.
Wow.
And he did not give me any breaks at all. You know, he flew a P-47 Thunderbolt, I think was the aircraft, over Nazi Germany and against some very defended targets. And had seen all kinds of things. And he told me some of the things I've seen you may never see in your life, but I'm not gonna keep you from going higher, from
right.
doing more. And so we look back at all the people that have done so much in our community that have overcome things. We shouldn't be afraid.
Right.
We should be able to go out and restore the community. And that's what I think your parishioners are trying to do. And everybody on this show, hopefully we can work together to do it.
Right, right. You know what? We got a young lady right here. Raise your hand, young lady. We got a young lady right here. Powerful young lady, I want to tell you. Very powerful young lady, got a shelter. She got a nonprofit organization.
Wow.
And only 30 years old.
Wow.
On the move, man. And if you can give her any tips or you know any open doors, or you may want to think about a partnership with her, I'm willing to put my connections out to her. Because
absolutely.
I see how she's on the move. You know what I'm saying? I don't do that with everybody. But I mean, 30 years old, Pastor Joyce, right here. A nonprofit organization, a shelter, on the move.
Well, if there's anything we can do to help, because people do need shelter.
Wow.
We'd be happy to. I've written a lot of grants, worked
wow.
on a lot of
you write grants too?
C3s. Yep.
Wow.
This is my seventh museum. So a science center. I worked at.
And she looking for a grant.
Shedd Aquarium in Chicago. Apple Planetarium.
You was led of God's spirit to come here today, young lady.
Yeah, I'd be happy to help.
Well, you know, we getting away with it now. I've been your host, Prophet Cedric Banks, along with
Prophet Dinetta Banks,
and along with
Christian Greer.
From where?
From the Michigan Science Center, President and CEO.
All right, President and CEO. Wow, you up there. So you, wow, I didn't know you were President and CEO, wow. So you saying, I can bring my church down and that's gonna be free, we ain't gotta pay no $15, $20?
Look, we're gonna have you guys down. I don't know how many people in your church, but we'll fit them in. And we'll see the 4D, the Toyota Engineering Theater, and we'll have them come down to see our 4D theater. And you can be my guest.
Do I have to, how much you gotta pay?
Just pay.
Oh, wow, all right. Well, we'll see you next Saturday night at 8 p.m. right here on the Community Shall Be Restored.
All right.
Can I get a witness? Hey.
Yes, sir.